Welcome and thank you for joining us in the Resume, Cover Letter, and References Workshop. Today we're going to go into detail on styles of resumes and how to create one, why we use cover letters and what we should say, and finally, who do we use as a reference and why. Let's begin with some background information on the services we offer. Second Chance has three office locations within Wellington County, including downtown Guelph and Stonewood Mall, as well as a Fergus location that serves all of Wellington County, including Erin, Rockwood, Palmerston, Mount Forest, and all of the communities in between. Services are tailored to you, such as creating and revising resumes and cover letters, assistance with interviews, training opportunities and career options, job development and matching program, access to job postings and resources, including faxing, photocopying, and computers, and everyone is welcome to use these services at no cost. Let's start by talking about what the purpose of a resume is. A resume is used as the first step to sell yourself to potential employers. It is a document that will highlight the information that you want or need an employer to know in order to show why you would be an ideal candidate for a position with their company. There are a variety of layouts you can choose from, including chronological, functional, or a combination. A chronological resume, which most people are used to seeing and using, lists your employment and volunteer history descending from most recent, usually going back no further than 10 years. This style of resume highlights each position you've held and what duties or responsibilities you've had as part of that job. A functional resume groups your related skills and abilities that you have to offer, but does not tie those skills to specific roles. Both resumes can be effective depending on the types of jobs that you are applying to. A chronological resume can highlight your movement throughout your career and the growth you've achieved to date. A functional resume can eliminate repetitive information if you've held several jobs with the same responsibilities, but it also highlights information quickly and easily for an employer. It is always recommended that you use the style of resume that you feel most comfortable with and that you believe sells yourself best to the employer. There is no right or wrong format. Here you will see that the candidate is using a chronological style resume, listing in descending order the position title, employer, and years of employment with the job details listed under each role. In this example of a functional resume, the candidate has grouped their skill set together and highlighted the two main areas where they have skills for the potential employer to be able to see quickly and easily. Below that, they list their work history in a descending order to show the titles they've held and with what employer. Some helpful things to keep in mind when writing a resume is that you want to prove to the employer that you're professional and have the skills and abilities to do the job they are hiring you for. The smallest mistake on your resume could raise a red flag for an employer and send you from the ideal candidate pile into the trash. First and foremost is to proofread, and better yet, have someone else proofread your documents prior to submission. Don't rely on spell check, as it is not foolproof and may not pick up on variations of spelling such as American versus Canadian, as well as grammatical errors. Secondly, if possible, keep your resume to one page, and if that's not possible, no more than two pages. Employers may have hundreds of applicants for a single position, and it's time-consuming to read two pages of info per candidate. In fact, studies show that employers may only spend 10 to 30 seconds reviewing a resume before deciding if you are a qualified candidate. Capture their attention in the first third of the page to give yourself a better chance of moving forward. Third would be to keep it neat. Not only does this mean clean and crisp, no wrinkles, folds, or handwritten corrections, but also a layout that is easy on the reader's eyes and leaves enough white space so as to not look crammed and overwhelming on the page. The resume is an effective document to highlight information for employers, but in addition, employers may require a cover letter. The purpose of the cover letter is to give the employer further insight on you as a candidate and how your experience and abilities meet their needs. The cover letter gives you the ability to go into further detail around your experience and skills and to demonstrate where you've used or built those skills with a deeper explanation than what is portrayed on your resume. If you haven't been able to capture all of what you have to offer on your resume, the cover letter may give you the ability to highlight key skills, experience, or education that has not been related to your current experience. The cover letter is a good time to mention skills built through volunteering, personal interests or hobbies, or self-directed education. Before you begin constructing these documents, take the time to self-evaluate not only what you have to offer, but also the type of job you're interested in and why. Making these connections allows you to easily identify the overlap of what an employer needs and wants are and what you have to offer that will meet them. Not only do you want to highlight the hard skills you've developed through past experience in education, but also your personality-based or soft skills that you have a self-awareness of and that come naturally for you. Take time to read through job descriptions and pick out key words or phrases that are used, match the language the employer is using, and give examples of where you've developed or used these skills in the past. Once you've done the self-evaluating piece, next you will do the role evaluating piece. Think about what you've identified as your skills and strengths, and then begin to look at job titles or industries that require people like you. Explore paid positions in areas that interest you on a personal level, possibly a hobby you have, an area where you've volunteered, or a job that can be a stepping stone to your future goals. Ultimately, your job satisfaction will increase if you're in a role where you have a keen interest in the product or service, build additional skills for the future, or have the opportunity to excel and move up within the industry as your experience grows. Before applying, put yourself in the employer's seat and think about what they may be looking for in ideal candidates. To build a strong application, do your research so that you know exactly what industry employers, aside from the one you're applying to, need and want in their employees. Not only will you be reviewing the job posting for the company you're interested in, but look at other employers or competitors and what they are looking for in candidates. Research similar job titles and roles to see what skills may put you above other applicants. And check the company website for inside information. Not only does this give you further insight on who the employer is and what they do, but it may also allow you to tailor your information so that it is more directly related to the specific employer you're applying to rather than just the role that has been posted. As with resumes, there are a variety of layouts and styles of cover letters that you can use. Take some time to research different styles to find one that works best for you. The most common style is simply a three-paragraph letter. The opening paragraph explains why you're writing, the middle paragraph is where you highlight what you have to offer, and the closing paragraph requests an interview and thanks the employer for their consideration. When writing a cover letter, always try to take a suggestive and positive approach. By telling the employer information rather than posing it as a question, it will show your confidence, which increases the employer's interest to find out more about you and confident that you are the right person for the job. In the second paragraph is where you can go into further detail to explain what you have to offer. Try not to repeat information that will be found in your resume, but rather build on that information with examples to demonstrate your knowledge and skills. Finish off the cover letter by coming back to the role you're applying to and the fact that you're interested in that position and that company. Do not ask the employer to contact you if they're interested. Instead, frame it in a manner that you will be meeting with them so it leads them to contacting you. This is not seen as pushy or bold, but rather that you're confident in yourself and what you have to offer. The purpose of references is to back up the information you've shared with a future employer. References should be provided at or after the interview and upon request. References could include a variety of people, including managers or supervisors, colleagues, volunteer, education, and character references. Depending on the job you're applying to, try to choose references that will best fit in order to relay the information that you have to offer to a potential employer. When creating your reference sheet, you want to provide your future employer with the details of who your references are, where they are from, and why you're using them as a reference. Always ask your references for permission to use them and keep them updated on your job search. Let them know any interviews that are scheduled, when, and with who, so that if they get a call or an email, they know why. While job searching, keep in contact with your references and remind them of the duties and roles from their experience with you that you want them to relate to potential employers. Provide their most up-to-date contact information and what manner they prefer to communicate with potential employers for their convenience. We hope you've enjoyed learning more about our services, resumes, cover letters, and references. If you need further assistance, the staff at Second Chance are here to help. Please do not hesitate to reach out to us to book an appointment so we can help you land that job.